Here, we have the standard sleeve surgical set for the conical connection. It is used in procedures with implant diameters ranging from 3.3 to 5 mm. The narrow sleeve kit is used for placement of 3.3 to 3.9 mm diameter implants. The narrow sleeve kit is used in tight spaces where the standard set may be too large. The narrow sleeve's inner diameter is 4 mm, where the standard sleeve's inner diameter is 5.5 mm. The first tools used are to prepare the site for drilling. The first tool that may be used in a flapless procedure is the tissue punch. This tool creates a circular hole in the gingiva, which creates an access point for the drills which follow to go into the bone. Following the tissue punch, a bone nail may be used to flatten an uneven ridge. It only removes bone to the level of where the top of the pre-planned implant will end up. After the site has been prepared, we can initiate the osteotomy with the starter drill. All tools and drills must engage the metal sleeve of the MGUIDE before turning on the drill. The starter drill is designed so that the tip of the drill comes into contact with bone only after the body of the drill engages the sleeves and center itself. For example, we can see how jumping to a 13 mm pilot drill without using the starter first may cause issues and inaccuracies. Now it is time to choose your path. The kit comes equipped with a series of drills for each length of implant. For example, we will choose the 11.5 mm since it matches the implant from our surgical plan. The best part about the MGUIDE set is that you have the freedom to change the implant size at the time of surgery. Now that we know the implant length and have chosen the right path, we will need to widen the osteotomy to the right diameter. In order to do that, we have two bone type references. For hard bone, we will use the scale on the bottom of the kit. For this implant, we will go up to the blue drill. In soft bone, we will use the scale on the upper part of the kit. If it had been a soft bone site, we would have stopped at the red drill for this implant. Now that we are ready to start drilling and have identified the right tools, the kit will help us in making the experience safe and simple. The drills and tools come with a built-in stopper to ensure that we don't perforate anything that we don't want to. The keyless system is the feature built into each drill that removes the need for any additional spoons or adapters that may overcomplicate the procedure. Since the drilling part of the procedure is complete, we can move on to place the implant using the tools in the smaller kit of the set. We can choose whether we want to place the implant in with a handpiece, a ratchet, or both. Other tools featured in the kit are fixation pins, fixation screws, and direct implant tools. Fixation pins are used in areas where we lack teeth for stabilization of the guide. A narrow drill is used to create the path for the pins to go into and stabilize the guide in bone. This is commonly used in edentulous cases. Fixation screws are used to stabilize the guide through any one of the sites where an implant will end up. This means that an MGUIDE with multiple sites can be stabilized using one of these sleeve sites right after the 6mm starter drill has been used. When picking an implant insertion tool, make sure to select the correct implant type and platform. MIS. Make it simple.